scheme is actually the 3-3-5 formation out of the Bengals and Ravens playbook. So if you look at my playbooks recently, when I put out the Bengal playbook, I said, if you want to see the video, go watch the Vikings playbook because it's identical and I already did the Vikings. The reason we're doing the 3-3-5 is it's the only formation Vikings didn't have. So let's talk about personnel first. For your D-tackle, you want a 3-4 type of D-tackle, so DeForest Buckner should work. For your defense that ends, you want good pass rushers. So Aaron Lynch is fine over here. Eric Armiston, I'm just going to leave alone. So your three outside linebackers need to be coverage guys. So we have Navarro Bowman, we have Ruben Foster, and we have Ray Armstrong. I'm going to put Malcolm Smith in, even though in real life he's hurt. Oh, I can't do that. And Ray loses us games, though. So I don't like him. Alright, whatever. We'll have to live with Ray Armstrong for a bit. For your... let's see. All three linebackers, yeah, coverage. Safeties are better off being coverage ball hawks. So I like the safeties being ball hawks. Since we're in regular teams, we don't have much to choose from. So Tart Reed and Ward are all in, because I subbed Jimmy Ward in as a third cornerback because I like him as a nickel. And that's our corners. If possible, you want block shedding corners. Both the Niner corners are actually pretty good on block shed. So if you play regular teams, the Niners aren't that bad. Offense, they're horrible, but, you know, regular teams. It's regular. Okay, so the first play we're going to look at in the nickel 3-3-5 wide is the double buzz. We're going to make sure it's a pass.
Righty. There go. White 90.
Base of line, press, pinch line, crash line left, shift linebackers right, and then blitz the nickel, which is over here. And that's the play you're gonna get. It looks very odd because they're in a offset. So during versus this kind of formation, I'd still run the blitz because look how fast Ward got in. Let's run it versus a regular style blitz or regular style offense like this one. So baseline press, pinch line, crash line left, shift linebackers right, and then blitz the nickel. And that's your blitz. See how fast that gets in. It's getting in pretty well. I like how fast that is. Right, so our next blitz is actually Tampa 2. So all we're going to do is we're going to base the line. We're going to spread the line out. We're going to shift the linebacker right. And we're going to blitz the left side linebacker. Okay, there we go. Linebacker's moved that time. And we said blitz the right. Let me redo that. Okay, Tampa 2, base of line, spread line, shift linebackers right, blitz the left side linebacker. There we go. That's what it'll look like. It looks a little bit like nickel 2. And that's all you're going to do. And it was a run play. Of course it was. So let's try that again. Alright, base of line. Spread line out, shift linebackers, glitz roll, or lobe. Now we'll run that. Oh, of all the empty plays, it was a QB draw. Oh my goodness. My Madden life is just comedy. Base of lines, spread line. Alright. This time it's going to be a pass. Spread. There it is. Okay. So it got picked up. It's kind of got in, but it kind of got picked up. So this is more of a picked up. So this time it didn't work. So just like I always say, blitzes are specialized. So if it didn't work, it probably wasn't meant to work against that team. For that play anyway, I guess. Because it could work in certain situations. So now back to 3-3-5. Loop crash 2 is our next one. Alright, so we're going to base the line, pinch switch D line, shift linebacker right, and that's it. Worked out right there.
Okay.
So the next play is a universal setup, which you can use in any play, but we're going to use it in this one anyway. We're going to base the line, we're going to press, we're going to pinch linebackers, we're going to shift the D line left, we're going to crash the D line out, and that's it. And Ward got in really quick that time too. That's why we like that. Overload 3 press is our next one. So overload 3 press. Overload 3 press. There you are. Alright, so we're gonna base the line press, crash the D line wherever you want, and hook the middle linebacker. And yeah, that's really it. This one's another simple blitz. That got him pretty well. I like it. Alright, let's see. Does dog all go the same as that one? Sometimes the name is a bit weird. Yeah, it's the same one. Okay, so this next blitz is nickel linebacker dogs in the playbook. In this one, it's actually called dogs all go. So we're man aligning. We're going to optional press. We crash the D-line middle, and we're going to hook the linebacker to help out, help coverage, and that's our user. So that got picked up, but it also clearly got in. So it's kind of one of those things. Alright, so free safety middle 3. Yep, there it is. Okay. We're gonna base the line, show blitz, blitz the nickel. He's over here. We're gonna put the left defensive end on a bluff blitz, which is you. And then we're going to user this linebacker to the left side, so he's basically gonna play over here. Blitz and it's run. That was some pretty good run stuff though. So, to be fair, that was pretty good.
Let's
make that. So baseline, show blitz, blitz nickel. Where are you at? Alright, so blitz nickel. So since the play's flipped, we're gonna have to flip everything. Put the left end on bluff blitz, so that means put the right end on bluff blitz. And then use the middle linebacker to the right. There we go. That's the best. Another very fast edge pressure, which is very nice. Cover 2 man. That's our next blitz. So, who showed me this? George Jefferson? I think this was is a Reddit guy. Who told me this? I don't remember when he told me this either. Shift the D-line towards the blitzing linebacker. So shift the D-line right. And then we're going to crash them down. We're going to spy the weak side's DN. So I'm going to bluff blitz them. And it's not 100% guaranteed quick pressure, but many times the C-linebacker is coming through untouched. Okay, so yeah, this is a play from a friend. And let's see, he got picked up, but it still got in just in time. I think he could have gotten a ball off easily, but whatever. So yeah, pretty simple setup. I'm going to bluff blitz Buckner this time. Actually, no, let's keep Buckner blitzed. Let's use Tart. How about that? User Tart. Try it that way. No, still got picked up. That one's not working very well. Let me try another way to see if... I know this, I've gotten this to work before. I'm just trying to find a good way to set up. So maybe if we get blitz you... The guy, blitz the guy manned up on the halfback. Bring the safety down. Actually blitz that safety. User Tart. So X is wide open, but Blitz did get through, so I guess that's one way to set that up. And yeah, that's basically all there is. Let's see, we have a cover 3, which is okay. All I'm gonna do with this is baseline press, shift linebackers, blitz that right side linebacker, blitz the middle linebacker, and that's our stock blitz in cover 3. And it got in, but my guy tripped. So that's pretty much it. This has been Tim from Madden Community College. Hope you enjoyed this 335 video. Let me know what your favorite defenses are and what you want to see next. All right, see ya.